It's Leah from Novato Gymnastics. How are you doing today? It's great to see you. Thanks for joining us here on our YouTube channel. Today, we're gonna work on some backward rolling, okay? So just make sure you have a lot of space around you. Make sure that you're not gonna knock anything over or hit anything or break anything while you're doing gymnastics today. And we'll get started. All right, so we're gonna start by warming up our bodies. So we're gonna just jog in place. Like this. All right, make sure to move those arms. Get them pumping just like you are with your feet. Okay, so you can get your knees up a little higher. Good job. All right, now we're gonna switch to booty kickers. Can you kick your bottom? Just like that. Nice job, keep going. Keep going. Together, keep going, apart, together. All right, now we're gonna try and cross over our bodies using our elbow and our knee. So we're gonna cross over and go like this. Don't do that, take the other one. Hit the other knee, elbow to knee. Elbow to knee, try and keep your elbows up nice and high instead of bringing them down like this. Okay, try it again. There you go. Good. See how fast you can go. I'm not very fast, but I'm trying my best here. It's all I want you to do too. Keep going. Should be getting a little warmer. Good job. Keep going. Keep going. Two more and two. All right, arms by your sides. We're gonna do some pencil jumping. So you're just gonna push through your toes. Try and keep your body nice and tight. Ready? Let's go like this. Two. Jump. See if you can land on your toes. And just keep jumping, squeezing really tight. Come on. All right. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Nice job, everyone. All right. Let's do some stretching. We're going to start with our legs apart, just like this. One hand on our hip. And let's reach the other one all the way over to the other side. See how far you can reach. Try not to go too low. Just reach up like you're reaching towards the corner of your ceiling. Okay? Good. Other side. Reach over. See how far so you can stretch. You should feel a nice side stretch here. Good job. All right, let's put our hands back on our hips. And from here, we're gonna bend forward. Is if we're going to try and touch the ground, okay? Now, you might not be able to touch the ground. That's okay. Go as far as you can. If you can touch the ground, just put your fingers lightly on there and see if you can look between your legs. Good. All right. Jump your feet together. Come into your squat. Can you balance? Arms out to the side. Arms up above your head. Arms in front. Ooh, almost fell over there. And then see if you can put your heels down and sit down. Great job, you guys. All right. We're going to sit in our pike here. Sit up nice and tall. And we're going to point our toes and flex and point and flex and point and flex and point and flex and circle. Make circles with your toes. Good, and then circle the other way, warming up our ankles here. Nice job. All right, reach up tall. Reach up really, really tall. I wanna see if you can touch the ceiling. And then you're gonna move forward, bend over. You're reaching for your toes or reaching right here on the ground next to your feet, okay? All right, so your hands should be on the carpet as far as you can go. And you're gonna slide forward and see if you can stay there. And hold it. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, and sit up. And then I want you to go back and forth 5 times. 1, just like that. 2, see how far you can go. 3, and 4, and 5. into our straddle. Remember, in our straddle, our knees are pointing up towards the ceiling. We don't want to see any sad straddles like this. We want to see a nice, happy straddle. And you're sitting up nice and tall, pointing your toes, knees are straight up towards the ceiling, and you're reaching from side to side and sitting up nice and tall. There's our happy straddle. Great. All right. Then you're going to put one hand in the front. The other one's going to reach all the way over. You're trying to see how far you can go over your leg and try and reach for your toes. Okay? Good. Hold it. Should feel a nice big stretch right here in your leg and in your side. Okay. Three and two and one. And then you're going to put one hand on each side. All right. And you're going to try and put your nose down as far as you can go. Remember to keep your leg nice and straight. If it starts to bend, that means you're going too far. You can try and look under your armpit. Make sure you're reaching really tall. Good. And then one hand on each side and nose down. Again, make sure your knees are staying straight and you're feeling that nice big stretch underneath. Good. All the way up. Happy straddle. Hands in the middle. And you can walk your hands forward. Okay. Again, only go as far as you can, so that your legs stay straight and your knees are pointing up towards the ceiling. Okay, so just go, if your knees start to bend, pull back a little bit or make your straddle a little smaller. Okay, so slide down, we're gonna hold it as far as you can. Hold it, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, a little bit more, 3, 2, and 1. Nice job, come up nice and slow. Grab your knees and see if you can pull your legs together just like this so that your knees or your feet are together. You can hold on to your toes. Okay, we're gonna push our elbows down, our knees, see if we can get them down a little further. Big stretch. Good, and then put your nose down to your toes. Good. Down and come up. Slide those feet forward. Wave at me with one hand, slide it under, wave at me with the other hand, and slide it under. Elbows are down, and try and get your nose down as far as you can. Good. Nice big stretch. I feel like a pretzel. How about you? All the way down. Good. And come up, and we're going to come onto our knees. Almost done here. We just got to warm up our wrists a little bit. Hands on your knees. Wiggle your fingers, slide them down. Oh, this is my favorite stretch. It feels so good on my wrists. Something we don't do very often, but it feels so great. All right, head up, palms up, and slide them down. Good job, everybody. All right, hands together. Let's roll them around like a meatball. And make some spaghetti. And sprinkle on some cheese. And reach up tall. Bend your elbow, pat yourself on the back, grab your other elbow, hand with you to your elbow, sorry, and pull it down as far as you can. You're trying to reach those fingertips down your back. Should feel a nice stretch here in your shoulders and your arms. Good. And reach up, pat yourself on the back, grab your elbow, and you're going to come down the other side. Reach as far as you can. Roll them forward and roll them backwards. Nice, everybody. All right, we're ready and warmed up and ready to get started. Back and forth. I feel like it's like a chicken. All right, we're ready. Okay, so as I said, we're going to work on some rolling today. We're going to start with some backward rolls. Now, backward rolls are a little tricky to do at home, so I'm going to show you some steps on how to do a backward roll, but if you can't do the whole backward roll, it's okay. You can just do the parts that I'm about to show you today. All right? All right. So, if you've done a backward roll before, we always start in this position. Do you guys know what this position is called? It's called a tuck position, okay? Our tuck position is so that we can stay nice and round, and it helps us to roll.
It's really hard to roll if we're in a straight shape, like a rocket body, right? So that's why we need to stay in a tuck shape, all right? So everybody get into their tuck. We're gonna start here by holding onto our knees and putting our nose down. See if we can get into a really tight ball, as tight as you can. Woo! All right, now we're gonna do some rock and rolls. And you can start by holding onto your knees just like this, and you're gonna rock back and forth. So forward and back.
Back and forward. Back and forward. Back and forward. There we go.
Good. Two more.
One
and two. Good. All right. We're ready for another challenge, okay? We're going to do some other rock and rolls here that are a little more tricky. We're going to try and lift our arms up and our toes up. So now we're balancing. You see that? Balancing here in my tuck. And I'm going to try and rock back and back up again without my hands or my feet touching the floor.
Back and forth. Back and forth.
Two more. And it's okay if you tip over. Just give it your best shot. Good job. All right. So those are our rock and rolls. Now, we're going to start with our backward rolls by doing our rock and rolls with our backward roll hands. Okay? So everybody do this with me. I'm going to show you first. Okay? I want you to pretend like you're holding up some pizzas. You're walking around holding these pizzas up. So you've got to keep your hands facing up towards the ceiling. All right? It's like our pizza hands. Okay? Then I want you to take your elbows and I want you to keep your pizzas up, but I want you to squeeze your ears just like this, okay? I know this is kind of an awkward position, but this is the position you need to be in when you're doing your backward rolls, okay? So palms are up, you're reaching back, your elbows are kind of reaching up, and you're squeezing your ears just like this. And I'm gonna show you why this is so important when you're doing your backward rolls, okay? If your arms are not squeezing in, and your arms are out like this, you're gonna drop your pieces and you're not gonna be able to roll, okay? So watch me first. I'm gonna do my rock and roll. I'm gonna turn sideways. I'm gonna show you first, okay? Pizzas up, squeeze your ears. Now watch my pizzas, watch my hands, okay? My hands have to smash my pizzas on the ground, okay? That is really key for backward rolls. You have to make sure that your hands touch the ground, okay? Pizzas up. Squeeze your ears with your elbows. You're gonna rock back, smash the pizza, and back up again. All right, you guys give it a try. I want you to try and do 10, okay? Make sure your pizzas are up. Squeeze your ears and rock back. And there's one. And two, keep going on your own. Make sure those pizzas are touching the ground. Every time ears are covered, keep going. And that's one more. Great job. Okay. So this is what I want you to see, what I see sometimes when I'm teaching backward rolls. A lot of times I'll see arms like this and their hands never really touch the ground. Okay, so that's not gonna work. I also see elbows out here. Okay, that doesn't help with backward rolls either. Another thing I see a lot of times is this. Okay, my legs are opening up nice and straight. My elbows are out. I want my legs to stay in a nice tuck, okay? So that's our backward roll, how we start our backward roll, all right? And we're gonna put this all together at the end, so don't worry. All right, now I wanna show you how we finish a backward roll. Now, in order to stand up from a backward roll, you have to be able to push your head up off the ground, okay? That's the tricky part. And it's a lot harder than it looks, okay? So this is how we practice. I'm gonna get into a mountain just like this. I'm gonna stick my booty up. My hands are flat on the ground. And I'm gonna try and bend my elbows nice and slowly and see if we can push back up again. Okay, these are called mountain push-ups. Bend your elbow as far as you can and push back up. Try and look at your toes while you're doing this. Head down and push. Head down and push. Good. Keep trying that, guys. Get into your mountain. I'm going to grab a little pillow right here. And this would be another alternative for you to do. Sometimes it's a little hard for you to reach all the way down to the floor. All right, so hands can go next to your pillow. Get into your mountain. You can bend your elbows, touch your head to the pillow, and push back up again. All right, bend your elbows to the pillow, and up, and bend your elbows, and up. Do two more on your own. Those are a little tricky, but they're going to help you stand up from your backward roll, okay? All right. So how we put the backward roll all together is normally on a backward roll, if I'm doing it on a flat surface like this, it's really tricky. If you were at the gymnastics center, we would be using what we call a wedge or a cheese mat to help you roll down. But since you probably don't have one of those at home, I'm going to show you how we try and do our backward rolls on a flat surface, like a mat or the floor, okay? I'll show you first what it looks like, okay? It's a little tricky to start from this position, but I want to show you how we're going to put all our parts together, okay? So we're going to put our pizzas up, squeeze our elbows. The other thing I want you to make sure you're doing is looking at your belly button. That's really important. If you don't look at your belly button, you're not going to be round enough to roll. So look at your belly button, pizzas up, ears covered, and you're going to roll back. And then there's my mountain push-up I have to use in order to, ta-da, stand up, okay? All right, now, if you're practicing this at home, it's really hard to do a backward roll and get all the way over if you're standing, if you're on the ground, okay? So sometimes I will ask you guys, if you're in class, to stand up before you do it, and it gives you a little bit more momentum. So I'm going to show you what that looks like, all right? So that way I start, this way I started my rocket body. I'm still going to make my pizzas, and I'm still going to squeeze my ears, but instead of sitting all the way down, I'm just going to bend my knees, just like this. So I'm kind of still in a tuck position, but I'm standing up, okay? So I'm squeezing my ears, I'm bending my knees, and then quickly I'm going to sit, and then I'm going to roll, okay? Ta-da! All right, so give it a try. You can start by sitting down, or you can start by standing up, whichever one works for you, okay? Just remember, feet together. The other thing, and make sure your knees are glued together, your pizzas are up towards the ceiling, and you're squeezing your elbows, and you gotta go really fast, okay? Good, I wanna see how many more you can do. All right, so you can pause this if you wanna keep doing your backward rolls. Keep trying, it's good for you to practice. Backward rolls are really tricky. But I think with some practice, you will be able to do them, okay? And maybe you'll come back to the gym and you can show me how you learned how to do backward rolls. All right. Great job, everyone. Let's do some cooling down now. All right. Let's start by doing some arm circles here. We're going to make big, big arm circles. Good. See how big and wide you can make them. Good. And big arm circles backwards. Baby ones forward. Feels a little different this way. Baby arm circles. And baby arm circles backwards. Good job, everyone. All right, open up your legs, and we're going to go side to side like a monkey. Good. I always like to say, like, you're tickling your armpits just like that. Good. Swing them back and forth. Nice job, everyone. All right, now we're going to put our feet together. We're going to get all the way up on our toes, just like this. And we're going to balance here. See if you can hold it. You hold it here, and then slowly, I want to see if you can bend your knees. Stay up on your toes, stay in releve. Ooh. And bend your knees slowly, slowly, slowly. And come all the way down onto your toes. Good. And then sit. Good. All right. We're going to bend our knees just like this. I'm going to take one hand and wrap them around our knees. And we're going to twist. So the other hand's going to come around your back. And you're going to try and twist this way first. Good. And try to look over your shoulder. Good. And the other side. Around your knees, and in the back, and twist. stretch up. And fold over your feet and see how far you can go. Maybe, now that your body's warmed up, you might be able to go a little bit further. Let's hold it there for 10 seconds. Ready? 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Great job, you guys. That was so much fun with you today. I hope that you'll keep practicing and keep playing these videos and doing your gymnastics at home. And we can't wait to see you back at the gym and you can show us everything you've learned over the break. All right, it was great to see you. I'll see you next time. Bye.